Alright everybody, welcome back to the Diver Guy channel. You know the drill by now. I make these videos because I wish I had somebody that would thinking, why would we talk about ballet? This is a channel about diving. Well, when you watch these two ballerinas do their spinny things, I forget what they're called, you'll notice that every time they come around, they fixate their eyes and their head forward, and then they spin around, and then they fixate again, and then they fixate, and then they fixate. Every time they do a spin, they're looking for that spot in front of them. And that's what you're going to do with diving too. Anytime that you're spotting and diving, you have to think it's all about head movement. And that's the first basic principle of this. Head movement and eye movement is so important. There's no way that you're going to be able to spot if you're keeping your head completely still the entire time, know what they're doing, so they give up. But keep that in mind. It's all about head movement and eye movement. We're going to come back to this idea a lot throughout this video. So for this video, we're going to talk about inwards and fronts mainly, and I think I'm going to do a second video for backs and reverses. So let's talk about the beginning. Step one, you have to have your eyes open. It's crazy how many people don't have their eyes open when they're diving. I've coached too many people that say they have their eyes closed. It's a diving sin. Don't do it. And if you are, stop it right now and open up your eyes, because there's no way that you're going to be able to spot unless you do. So that's step one. Step two is it's time to decide what you're going to look at. Some people like water below you or just out a little bit in front of the board, because the surroundings may change at each pool that you go to. Anytime you're at an away meet, the walls are going to be different. They might be further away from you. So the spotting will have to change if you're spotting the walls or something else. But the one thing that never changes is the water and the board. The board is always going to be underneath you and the water is always going to be there, I hope. And if not, if you're not spotting the water, you have to really figure out what you're looking for and decide that up front before you start practicing your dives. So that's the main thing for step two. Step three, we're talking about the head position again. You're going to notice that on all these videos that we're going through right now, for the majority of them, their head position is at least neutral on their takeoffs. I think diving mechanics have gone back and forth between chin up and neutral head position on the takeoffs for fronts and inwards. As long as you're not ducking your head, you're going to be okay for the most part. And then if you're a beginner, start off small. We're just going to do a front dive tuck, and you're going to keep your eyes on the water. It's a little bit overkill to have your head up super high. And in this video, they don't really over-exaggerate at all. But what you want to do is just on your takeoff, make sure you have the neutral head or eyes up longer. And then once you're in the air into the tuck, keep your eyes on the water where you're going to land. That's spotting right there. You're looking for the water below you and you're seeing everything ahead of that. So on the takeoff, you're going to see out far. You're going to see the back wall that you're looking at or wherever you're looking on the takeoff. And then as you're going up into the air, you're going to track inward. So your eyes are going to start out far and then you're going to slowly bring your gaze down to the water that you're gonna enter at. And when you really feel like you're seeing it very well, try a front 1.5. You're going to be doing the same takeoff. You're going to add a little extra throw, go into the tuck. And when you come out of the dive, if you can pike out, please do. And if you don't jump high enough for a pike out yet, make sure that you just keep your chin up on the out. Right here, you'll see he's looking kind of down, almost like he's looking through his legs. Really, what you want to do is look out in front of your feet and then track down to the water. There's going to be a lot of tracking involved, which means you don't want to look directly where you're trying to go in. You want to look out ahead of that and then bring your gaze down to where you're going in. And that's the basics of spotting right there. Once you can do a front 1.5 like that and you're ready for 105, go for it. And depending on your level, this is literally all you do. You lock in on the easy dive and then you try to transfer that skill to the next amount of flips. And that makes it harder because inherently adding a flip makes the dive more difficult and it requires better board work and strength in order to do it in the first place. But on the spotting side of things, in order to spot these harder dives, you have to be able to process the dive a lot faster. You have to be able to see it quicker and you have to be able to react a lot faster and have that muscle memory down on these outs. That's what's important about those comeouts that we were talking about with the front 1.5. If you can keep your chin up and your eyes out, you're going to have a much easier time doing it on a front 2.5 and a 3.5. Or a 4.5. The more you get that muscle memory down for the out, the better your spotting will become and you'll be able to fix the entries as you come out, because you're not going to come out at the perfect time every single time. But if you're able to make adjustments after you come out, you'll have a much better time with your entries. So this whole time I've just kind of been spewing out things about spotting and not really talking about any of these dives super specifically. And the truth is there's so much to spotting that it's hard to really fit in one video. I really want to give you these fundamentals, which is really the head position on the takeoff and then looking for the water as you come around for each somersault. And now we're going to go over some more examples of what it could really look like once you master it. So first, let's talk about head position on the start. with this example here, Olympic gold medalist, look at this takeoff. We're really just focused on head position for this. We're not really as focused on anything else with the body because that is what we're talking about in this video. But look at that. Look at where he's looking at, like, the end of the board, which is in phenomenal head position, keeping your head up. There's other aspects about this that aren't perfect, but that's really great. And that sets him up for really good spotting as he flips. Head up on the start means that his head is in a better position as he comes around to see so much more. Now you can imagine if his head was down on the start and it stayed that way all the way through here, his chin would be ducked and he'd be looking at his knees. He wouldn't be able to look out above his legs in order to see the rest of the dive that's passing by him. He'd be looking at his own body, which does not help for spotting. So let's talk about where head position can go wrong. Let's do this final person. We get a little lazy with what we're willing to do because it takes a lot more effort. You don't even notice it in real time, body movement and head movement that he's doing throughout the flip. Every flip he does, he's looking for the water. He comes around for front 1.5, head up, sees the board, sees the water, goes back into the pike. Comes around for 2.5, sees the board, sees the water, back into the pike. By then, he knows the cadence of his flip speed, and then he can line it up. He knows exactly the timing he needs. But think about how that can help you as you learn your 2.5s or front 3.5, which are more common. This is obviously a very difficult dive that most people won't ever do, but the concept is what we're trying to take away from this. Apply this to your inward 1.5. You come around for the 1.5, you look for it, see it, and then line up. Don't just go straight for the water. You'll see that a lot where people just try and go right for the water and they rush the entry. See it first, then line it up. You have to be able to make those adjustments. So that's going to be the basics for the front and inward spotting. I hope that was helpful. It felt like I went through that pretty fast. But the last thing I want to talk about before we leave is how you can do it without being in the water. So take a look at these videos of people doing a trampoline skill called a ball out. And that's literally just going front flip to your back over and over and over again. So if you have a trampoline, practice this. You can do like a couple in a row. And as you're going up into the air, tilt your chin up as if you're nodding up and see the trampoline as you go by and repeat. Just practice that head movement and eye movement, locking in on the trampoline bed every time you do the flip. That's going to really train your ability to do this outside of the water. And like I said, I hope that was super helpful. I'm going to go over back and reverse spotting in the next video, and I'll see you then. Talk to you guys later. Bye.